Hi guys, welcome to my channel Sushruta. Today our topic is on Stellar Evolution and Pteridoe Fights. And let's begin from the roots of what a steel, what it consists of and what is its function. Okay? Now we are not in a hurry. Let's learn the subject. Okay? First, what is steel? Steel means it is the central cylinder or core of vascular tissue in higher plants and pteridophytes. It consists of xylem, phloem, and even pericycle, medullary rays, and pith. If present in this stellar evolution, pith will also definitely come. The fundamental parts of stem and root are epidermis, cortex, and steel. In those fundamental parts, we now are studying about the steel. Okay? Next, function. It is important. What is the main function of the steel? Why is it important to plants? Its function is to transfer of water, nutrients and photosynthesis. As steel is present both in stem as well as root, so it transfers these materials from root to stem and stem to leaf. Okay? Steel is the fundamental unit in the vascular system of pteridophytes. It is the fundamental unit in the vascular system of pteridophytes. And let's come to our topic, stellar theory. Okay, first, look at this. Here, these are the types of steels in plants. It is totally first divided into three types: protosteel, siphonosteel, and solenosteel. Some author even says that solenosteel is the subdivision of siphonosteel. You don't need to worry. You can write in any way. You don't need to worry about it. First, protosteel. This steel has no pith present in it. It is the primary steel, first formed steel. This is the ancient one. Under these protosteel, we have haplosteel, actinosteel, plectosteel, mixed protosteel, and mixed protosteel with pith. Sir, you said that the steel without pith is protosteel, but here it is with pith. Because it is the connecting link between siphonosteel and protosteel. Okay, it is the connecting link, mixed protosteel with pith. And next, siphonosteel, steel with pith and no leaf gaps, that means leaf gaps are absent, is siphonosteel. Ectophloic siphonosteel and amphiphloic siphonosteel are present, two types. Cladophilic siphonosteel is also present, in which it is not much asked and it is not as well as important. It is mostly used in MSc times, so you don't need to write about it. Next, solenosteel. Steel with pith and leaf gap. That means both pith as well as leaf gaps are present. These are six types. They are ectophloic solenosteel, amphiphloic solenosteel, dictyosteel, polycyclic steel, eusteel, and atactosteel. Okay, you can take a picture of this. Next. Let's come to our main topic, stellar theory. Stellar theory was proposed by Van Thiemann and Doliot in 1886. Term steel was first used by them in stellar theory. That means the term steel was first used by Thiemann and Doliot. The steel is separated from the cortex by endodermis. That means cortex and steel are present by are separated by endodermis. In between, the endodermis is present. Endodermis, it is the innermost layer of the cortex, and pericycle is the outermost portion of the steel. Okay, next, different types of steels. As I said before, first, on the basis of ontogeny and phylogeny, there are three categories of steels in vascular plants. They are protosteel, siphonosteel and solenosteel. I said you before now. And first, let us study about the protosteel. Protosteel, as I said you before, this was the ancient steel. Okay? Primary steel is protosteel. A steel in which the vascular core consists of a solid core of xylem and it is surrounded by phloem, pericycle and endodermis is called protosteel. That means in center xylem is present, and surrounding it, concentric rings of phloem, pericycle and endodermis is called protostele. In this, pith is absent. I said you before in the flowchart. It is the simple stellar organization in vascular plants and most primitive. Most primitive means from the beginning. Okay? At firstly formed. And it is the simple stellar organization. When compared to siphonostele and solenostele, protostele is the most simple stellar organization in vascular plants. Next, majority of the pteridophytes show protostelic condition in their rhizome, stem or roots. Majority of the pteridophytes. There are 5 types of protosteles. They are haplostele, actinostele, plectostele, mixed protostele and mixed protostele with pith. Okay? Let's see them. First, haplostele. A protostele with central solid and smooth core of xylem surrounded by concentric layers of phloem is known as haplostele. That means look at here. It is haplostele. Central xylem and it is surrounded by phloem, endodermis, pericycle and cortex. These are the concentric layers which are surrounded by the xylem. It is the most primitive type of protostele. Yes, actually protostele is the most primitive one. In protostele, haplostele is the most primitive one. Okay, it is present in fossil genera like Rhynia and Horneophyton and living genera like Selaginella, Crossiana, Lycopodium, Cernum. Okay, next, actinostele. Here we have the diagram even for actinostele. Xylem in the form of radiating arms. Look here, you have 5 radiating arms. Their number is not present, but radiating arms are present. And phloem in isolated patches alternating with xylem. That means see, here these white spaces are phloem, which is alternating with the xylem, radiating arms, okay? Both haplostele and actinostele was recognized and named by Brebner in 1902. Okay, examples of actinostele is Psilotum, Lycopodium, Ceratum. Actinostele may show variations due to breaking of xylem tissue into different forms. There are 3 types of steles: plectostele, mixed protostele and mixed protostele with pith. Some authors say that these 3 are subdivisions of actinostele and some say that these are the special steles present in protostele. You can learn in any way. First, plectostele. In this type of stele, the xylem and phloem occurs in the form of small parallel plates which alternates with each other. Look here, this is the xylem and alternating with the white one as phloem. Xylem, phloem, xylem, phloem. In this type, the small parallel plates are arranged. Example, Lycopodium clavatum and Lycopodium volubile. It is plectostele. Next, mixed protostele. The name itself says. Xylem is divided into several units or groups. Each xylem units are scattered inside the ground mass of phloem. See, here the white space is completely phloem and the blue rounds, blue marks are xylem. Okay? These xylem is divided into several units and that units are scattered in the phloem. Okay? That is mixed protostele. Mixed protostele. Example, Lycopodium cernum. Mixed protostele with pith. It is important. Look, advanced type of stele among protosteles. That means it is the advanced. It has most advanced characters among all other protosteles. Okay, like haplostele, actinostele, plectostele, mixed protostele. It is most advanced. And the formation of pith in the stele started here. For the first time in the evolution, in the stellar evolution, pith is first formed in mixed protostele with pith. It is another type. Okay. Stele is similar to mixed protostele. That means the stele is same with the mixed protostele. But here the pith is present separately. It is the connecting link between protostele and siphonostele. I said before, this mixed protostele with pith is the connecting link between protostele and siphonostele. Example, hymenophyllum and demissum. Look, take a photograph about this. Next, the second one, siphonosteel. It is a modified form of protosteel in which the pith is present in the center of the steel. This is also termed as medullated protosteel. Okay, medullated protosteel. Here, the central pith is surrounded by cylinder of xylem and phloem. Origin of siphonosteel. The siphonosteel is derived from protosteel by the formation of pith in the center. That means the siphonosteel with a pith is known as, the protosteel with a pith is known as siphonosteel. The centrally placed xylem core in the protosteel is replaced by parenchymatous pith. That means the pith is made up of parenchymatous cells. It replaced the xylem core, which is present at the center. There are two theories regarding the origin of pith in the siphonosteel. They are interstellar origin of pith and extrastellar origin of pith. In this interstellar origin of pith, according to this theory, the innermost, that means centrally placed, vascular tissue in a protosteel changes into parenchymatous cells. That means the pith. Okay? This theory is proposed by Bauer in 1923. And supported by Fahn in 1960. That means in between many scientists are present, but we don't need to discuss about all of them. This is the most widely accepted theory of pith development. Many scientists accepted this theory, but the second theory was not accepted by many scientists. Okay, let me show you and let me tell you about it. Second theory is extrastellar origin of pith. According to this theory, one pith is formed as a result of the invasion of cortical parenchymatous cells into the steel. The invasion of pith occurs through leaf gap or branch gap. This theory is proposed by Jeffrey, but this theory was not mostly or widely accepted because from the leaf gaps, they will definitely will not go. That means the invasion does not occur, but this theory gave it. So many of the authors or who studied about the pteridophytes have rejected this theory. They followed the first theory, that is intrastellar origin of pith. Okay. Next, different types of siphonosteels. Two types, right? Depending on the position of xylem and phloem, two types of siphonosteels are seen. They are ectophloic siphonosteel. In this, phloem is present only on the external side of the xylem. Phloem is present only on the external side of the xylem. Wait, let me show you. Look here. This is ectophloic diagram. Here, xylem and phloem. Only it is present on one side. That too, outer side of the xylem. Okay? See, phloem is present only on the external side of the xylem. The centrally located pith is surrounded by the concentric layer of xylem and phloem. Of course, see, this is the pith present. It is surrounded by xylem and that is surrounded by phloem. Okay? Look at the diagram carefully. If you remember the diagram, you can completely write this answer. Next, leaf traces are present but leaf gaps are absent. Yes, remember this point. Leaf gaps are absent in siphonosteels. Where it is present? It is present in solenosteels. Example, Osmunda and Skysia. Second one, amphiphloic siphonosteel. Phloem is present on both sides of xylem cylinder. That means on external side and internal side, inside and outside. The central portion of the steel is occupied by pith. Yes, we know that. Pith replaced steel. Next. Xylem on its inner side is surrounded by inner phloem, inner pericycle and inner endodermis. Same to its outer side also, yes. On outer side also, it is surrounded by outer phloem, outer pericycle and outer endodermis. Look here. Look at the diagram carefully. It is the xylem. The blue line is xylem. And inner to it, the inner phloem, inner pericycle and inner endodermis are present. And outer to it, outer phloem, outer pericycle and outer epidermis are present. It is amphifloic. Amphi means two, both inner and outer sides. Okay. Example, Marsilia and Edianthem. Solenosteel. Solenosteel is also one of the subdivision of siphonosteel. Siphonosteel with leaf gap is called solenosteel. That means, as I said you before in the flowchart, this siphonosteel with leaf gaps is called solenosteel. This solenosteel has leaf gaps present along with the pith. Six different types of solenosteels can be seen. They are, first one, ectophloic solenosteel. It is mostly similar to ectophloic siphonosteel, but except leaf gaps are present. In ectophloic siphonosteel, leaf gaps are absent. Derived from ectophloic siphonosteel, thus phloem is present only on the outer side of xylem. Yes, and leaf gaps are also present. Okay. Amphiphloic solenosteel, derived from amphiphloic siphonosteel. So phloem is present on both sides of xylem. Phloem is present on both sides of xylem. Example, Edianthem parietum. It is also mostly similar to amphiphloic siphonosteel. Okay. And leaf gaps are present in this. Dictyosteel. The siphonosteel with overlapping leaf gaps are called dictyosteel. That means, let me show you. This is dictyosteel. These gaps are leaf gaps present in the siphonosteel. The siphonosteel with these leaf gaps are present as dictyosteel. That means here, the overlapping leaf gaps are called dictyosteel. Yes. So the steel becomes broken into longitudinal strands or meristeels. Here, these are meristeels. Okay. Example, pteridium and dioptris. Polycyclic steel. Here the steel is present as two or more concentric cylinders. Yes, poly means two or many. Example, pteridium species comes under polycyclic steel. And eusteel. If the steel is split into distinct collateral vascular bundles, then it is called eusteel. These bundles are arranged in a ring shape. Example, dicot stem. Wait, let me show you this eusteel. See, this eusteel. That means xylem and phloem are present, and these vascular bundles are seen as ring shaped. Okay, they are arranged in a ring. Okay, ring shape. This is eusteel. Next example is most dicot stems. Atactosteel. It is the final steel and most advanced one. Vascular bundles are scatteredly distributed in the ground tissue. Example, monocot stem. That means, let's look at this diagram. See, here vascular bundles are scattered. They are not in any circular fashion or in any shape. They are scattered in the ground tissue. This comes under the atactosteel. Examples are the monocot stem. Okay, you can take the pictures of this one also, and even these three diagrams also. That's it for today, guys. If you like this video, please like, share, and subscribe to my channel, Sushruta. Bye bye, guys. Meet you in the next video.